ISUPK.
It says he chose you.
And right. Guess what? By the Lord choosing you, you got stuff you gotta do. You gotta follow the laws of this book. You scared of the truth. You scared of the goddamn truth, that the truth hurts.
That's right.
Right.
Truth is, you've been bamboozled. The white man, he claims he loves you, but guess what? He's incapable of loving you. Because he's a goddamn beast. Like the brother brought up. In order for you to love somebody, you gotta be able to have compassion. And these people have no compassion.
That's right.
They are incapable of loving you. It's just not in them. That's the spirit that the Lord gave them, and the spirit that the Lord gave us is to be goddamn soldiers.
Right.
The Lord is a man of war, and so am I. That's why I'm up here. I'm going to war for my people. Black people that's on this side. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians. You got any more on that?
Count out of one cup.
Let's go. Above all people.
Above who?
Above all people.
The black man in America is above who?
All people.
The Spanish man in America is above who?
All people.
The Native American Indians is above who?
All people.
Freedom.
That are upon the face of the earth.
Upon the face of the earth.
There you have it. The Lord chose blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians to be above all people on the face of this earth. That is not equality. That is actually racism. To be a racist means you love your race, stock, or lineage, or nation of people. And guess what? The Lord only loves blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians. Black people, get with the program. Let's get 2 Ezra 6 and 54. Let's see if the Lord loves all people. We're going to continue this. We're going to keep continuing to bring out that the Lord only loves one race of people, and that's the nation of Israel. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians. Let's go.
2 Ezra, chapter 6, verse 54. And after these, Adam also.
Right. So we're bringing out the fact, it's going into Adam. Read on.
Whom thou madest Lord of all thy creatures.
Right, and the word Lord means master. So Adam was made master over all creatures, right? That's everybody and everything. Read on.
Of him come we all.
Everybody come from Adam, right? Black people come from Adam. White people come from Adam. Hispanics, Polynesians like the brother brought out. Hawaiians. Everybody you see, right?
And the people also whom thou hast chosen.
Right, so everybody came from Adam, but guess what? The Lord chose one particular group of people. Everybody came from Adam, even the people that the Lord chose. Read on.
Verse 55. All this have I spoken before thee.
Read on.
O Lord, because thou madest the world for our sake.
The Lord made the world for our sake. Our is a possessive pronoun. It didn't say he made it for everybody's sake. Why would the Lord love everybody? That is a misconception that's getting torn down today. We're the ISUPK, man, and we ain't no goddamn power. If you think you can combat with the Bible, then come up here and combat with the Bible. You got some scriptures that prove that God loves everybody? Bring them on. Bring on.
Verse 56, as for the other people.
As for who?
The other people.
As for the white man.
The other people.
As for the Arabs.
The other people.
And them goddamn stinking ass Africans.
The other people.
Read on.
Which also come of Adam.
Read on.
Thou has said that they are nothing.
The other people that come from Adam, the other people that's not on this chart right here, the Lord said they are what?
Nothing.
The Lord said Arabs are what?
Nothing.
Africans are what?
Nothing.
And the goddamn white man is what?
Nothing.
That's right.
But be like unto spittle.
But be like unto spittle. The white man is goddamn spit. Every other nation other than that's on this sun right here, the Lord says they are all spit.
Damn right.
And fly out your damn mouth. How nasty, how sick is that? Be on.
And has likened the abundance of them unto a drop that falleth from a vessel.
Meaning if you grab all these nations, if you grab all these heathens and put them all together, they don't weigh nothing. They can't stand up to the Lord's army.
Read on.
And now, O Lord, behold, these heathen,
the white man, the Arabs, the Africans, everybody that I just named that had black people, Hispanic, and Native Americans in slavery, read on.
These heathen, which have ever been reputed as nothing.
So these heathen that's always been reputed, always been called or thought of as heathens,
read on,
have begun to lord over us and to devour us.
Right, they have become to be lords over us. The Lord made the world for our sakes. Why the hell is the goddamn white man over top of black people right now? Everybody claim they African. Why the hell is the African over top of you right now? Why would you want to be equal to a goddamn dude that washes his hands in cow piss? I know I don't got the same spirit as that. You can't tell me I'm African.
Right.
God damn it. Read that from the top.
And now, O Lord, behold, these heathen, which have ever reputed as nothing, have begun to be lords over us and to devour us.
Right, because we want to be equal to them. If you ain't celebrating Passover a few months after Hanukkah, damn it, you don't love the Lord, and the Lord for sure don't love you. Hanukkah, contrary to popular belief, is not the holiday of the little white Jewish man with them pepperoni fried bologna hats on. Matter of fact, drop that, give me Isaiah 46 and 3. They know who we are. Ask your rabbis who the real Hebrews is. They're gonna tell you that black man walking down the street with his pants hanging down, that's the real Jew. And you can't convert to being a Jew. You have to be born. It gotta be in your bloodline, man. Let's get it.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 46, verse 3. Hearken unto me, O house of Jacob.
Listen to me, O house of Jacob, whose name was changed to Israel, the father or progenitor of blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians, read on.
And all the remnant of the house of Israel.
And all the remnant of the house of Israel. So everybody on this side right here, if you black, if you Hispanic, or if you Native American Indian, this is talking to you. Read on.
Which are born by me from the belly.
Which is born by me through the belly. In order for you to be an Israelite, you gotta be born through the belly. You can't convert. It is nothing that you feel. It's nothing that's spiritual. You have to be born. It's running through my veins.
That's right.
I'm an Israelite by blood.
That's right.
I am a Jew by blood.
That's right.
My forefather was Judah, Yehoiada, in the Hebrew. What I asked you for before, we can drop that. I just wanted to prove the fact that you can't be no goddamn Jew by religion. The men that you see standing up here before you, the priests and prophets from the Israelite school of universal and practical knowledge, these are the real Jews.